Hello, welcome back. More Dota 2 coming your way for the Kiev European Major Qualifiers.
I can't hear you.
And I cannot hear you.
Something has broken.
John, something has
while
changed.
We've been outside for 10 minutes.
Well, I did ask.
Is it muted on Rob the mixing desk?
What? Where is it muted? And the people at home can't hear us. We just cannot hear us. You want to get Rob?
It's going through .tv as well. This is fine then. This is fine, right?
Is it?
Yeah.
I'm removing one earpad so I can actually hear you then.
Unmute Dota? Like, that's not going to fix our mics though, right?
No. Oh, maybe it is.
No, there's no way.
No, that's
of course
not.
No,
that didn't fix our microphones. I did unmute Dota.
I'm sure
this is fine.
Oh well. Everything's working as intended.
You want to go get Rob? Rob is the fixer of everything.
Can Rob hear us? Can we wave at the camera and like alert?
No, he can't. Well,
I mean, if
we wave long enough,
if it's going through XSplit, it's fine, right?
What?
It's going through XSplit.
It's going through XSplit. I see the bars.
It's going into Dota TV.
It's going into Dota TV because our bars show up.
10 seconds remaining.
We just can't hear each other.
We just cannot hear each other.
Shiva's repeating everything I say.
5 seconds.
I'm not sure what you're saying. What button should I twist? See, there's so many buttons, I'm afraid to twist any.
Reserve time.
You think it's that one?
Radiant team ban.
Is he telling you to twist a button?
No.
You're just like randomly saying, let's twist some knobs, guys. It's okay, Shiva.
Hey, why is that one up and that one to the side?
That's just volume.
10 seconds remaining.
Are you then a lot louder than I am?
No.
Or am I a lot softer
dire
than you are?
Dire team ban.
Know. I don't know.
All right.
Alternate attacks against Bean Boys.
Alternate attacks versus Bean Boys. Both teams haven't got a loss yet. Win yet. Both teams have
win. They've got lots of losses. Yes. They've got lots of losses.
They haven't won a game yet.
Radiant
and,
team pick.
I want to try and put this nicely. But then I tried, and then I didn't even get the chance to try before Gareth basically ruined it because he said this is the competition of the trash cans.
I said nothing of the sort. Yes, those words have left your mouth, not mine.
You said that right before this game started.
When?
And I asked you,
I don't
can
remember
I coach
this.
You on that? And you said, yeah, sure.
I think you blacked out while playing Zelda and dreamt about this or
Reserve
something.
No.
This never happened.
See, you might be sleepy and sleeping all the time. I'm wide awake.
Like gladiators of the dumpster.
Dire team pick.
See, I wouldn't even have come up with that.
At least one of these teams will leave this qualifier with a win.
Yes. But they both will leave the qualifier.
Yep.
Wow. 10 seconds there's still hope and chances and dreams and things. Guys, that's
dreams.
What we're here for.
Dreams. And unicorns and fairy dust.
Yeah, and rainbows. Mm. And pots of gold.
Except rainbows actually do exist.
Pots of gold do exist as well.
Not at the bottom of rainbows, though.
I didn't say that they were.
10 seconds remaining.
She's got me there, actually.
Let's focus on the draft. We do have a draft going on right now. Team Alternate Attacks, they went for the Earth Spirit. Faceless Void, Nyx Assassin opening with the Rubik Weaver and the Outworld Devourer.
Reserve time.
As opening for the Bean Boys.
Hmm.
And we have a lot of mids removed from the pool by Bean Boys with Invoker, Shadowfiend, and Tinker.
Dire
so we'll see what mids are left to go up against the OD.
Especially mids that pair well with Void, right? You want heroes that can dump a lot of damage inside of the Chrono.
Yeah.
Invoker banned out because that's one of Alternate Attack's like best heroes, Exotic
yeah.
Deer. Catsul plays their Earth Spirit,
remaining.
If I remember correctly. This is a team that's kind of been, you know, around in the
remaining.
Sort of middling tier 2, tier 3 European scene for a long time now. But they've struggled to kind
time.
Of break out. They've got some very good players. They've got a couple of brothers. They're very, very young. They got like, you know, 15, 16-year-old players on their team. Against the experience of Bean Boys and the way
Dutch.
That Bean Boys have been playing and the fact they're Dutch, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a massive factor when it comes
I
to playing
so.
Dota 2. Absolutely. It's going to be a tough one.
Imagine how much lower my MMR would be if I weren't Dutch. Logic. Yeah, there's 5-minute delay, so you can't see if our audio works. I think that's what you were trying to do.
I'll just leave chat open and see if people start flaming us for being idiots or something.
You mean people are actually watching us?
No, there's no one.
I mean, mean, it is a battle of the trash cans. No, that's not true. That's unfair. Both of these teams, they've worked hard to get invited on the side of Alternate Attacks. They've been around for a very long time. And Beam Boy is obviously making it through the qualifier, which, to be honest, I think is quite a feat.
Like, both of these teams have basically been put into a stacked pool, right?
Yes.
The European qualifiers are
stacked. And there's no other way to put it.
Yeah, they are probably, like, one of the hardest qualifiers we've ever seen for a Valve event. You know, the fact you've got Bears that are just, like, stomping through. Cloud9 and Alliance are both performing well.
Secret that is expected to do well as well. Remaining. Mm. Ninjas in Pyjamas, which, I mean, their results today haven't been super amazing, but they're still a tough team to go up against. And yes, making it through the open qualifiers alone was a tough thing to do. That even was a very stacked qualifier. And for a team to come together fairly short before this event.
I mean, even I got knocked out in the round of 64. And I'm amazing at this game.
For a team that come together so close to this event. And then making it all the way through the open qualifiers. It's quite impressive for the Sing Sing stack, as people call them. Although, to be honest, it might just be a Council stack. Because Council has been playing really well.
Dire team back.
Even though he has been targeted a lot as well, and that's probably why we see so much focus on the mid hero being together with the face of Void. I also don't hear the dire team in-game pick. Sound.
Me neither. In fact, I hear nothing.
Me neither. Wait, I know what to do.
10 seconds.
I'm sure
remaining.
I can text, right?
Sure. Well, yeah, the mid lane's been a massive kind of point of contest for Bean Boys. Probably one of the bigger reasons why Boogie has been drafting himself these very heavy roaming heroes, you know, Earth Spirit, Spirit Breaker, guys that can just move very quickly from lane to lane when danger starts to poke its ugly head out. But alternate attacks with the Clinks. Physical right-click damage dealer can pile the DPS into the chrono. But does this move...
5 seconds remaining.
Now I'm confused, actually. Earth Spirit roaming, Nyx Assassin likely offlane. Is this a Mirana with a Nyx dual offlane Clink safe? They have a really weird kind of laning setup with their heroes, right? There's no like dedicated five role support in the same context we'd use
so
it
I'm
in other drafts.
So Nyx Assassin offlane, mm-hmm. Clink's mid, Faces Void safe lane.
And then Mirana Earth Spirit roaming.
Earth Spirit. Maybe that's a little bit too greedy though.
So that's my issue, is that Mirana and Earth Spirit both fulfill very, very similar roles as, you know, roaming, collecting bounty runes and applying pressure to lanes. But that pressure doesn't come from just them, it comes from the natural laners themselves, you know, having a Rubick or something on your lane plus a carry, and then you move forward with the Mirana from the side. Whereas Bean Boys, I feel, have got like a much more natural feeling draft, you know, they've got initiation tools through Beastmaster,
yep.
OD Rubick, Ogre and Weaver pair up very nicely with the Bloodlust onto OD as well, actually. They've got so much attack speed. Inner Beast and Bloodlust. If these guys can stay alive in fights and maybe kite a little bit with Primal Roar and Astral and get away from Void Chrono, they've got a lot of damage to output.
Remaining.
We'll see how much damage they can actually put out, because I think that alternate attacks with the draft they remaining. Have. I mean, as you said, we still don't know for sure where everybody's going to go, but they have some heavy focus with the roaming heroes, so some heavy focus on the laning stage there, so hopefully for them. They can get their advantage there and see how they do. Let's see who's playing what. We have Earth Spirit played by Elisash, Kasora playing the Nyx Assassin, Nisha playing the Mirana, Exotic Deer on the Clinks, Double G is playing the Faces Void, and then on the Radiant side we have Bean Boys, with Boogie playing the Ogre Magi, OD being played by Cancel, Sing Sing is playing the Weaver, Celery is the Rubick, and then Bambo is playing Beastmaster. We saw Beastmaster, or rather, we saw Bambo play earlier, and he was playing. Why does this thing automatically zoom so far in?
I was going to ask you why you keep zooming in so far. But
no,
but you can
like
see the meme.
All right.
It's just like automatically zooming in and out.
Wait, this is normal? Yes? We agree?
Mm.
I am not touching the mouse.
I think you're a little bit out, actually.
Well, if I'm a little bit out, it will auto-fix itself.
Cool. Zoom into the meme, Shiva.
Well, this is not what I'm doing.
Uh-oh, you freaking moron! You just got beaned! Tag your friends to totally bean them!
Oh my god. You're a horrible person.
What? Because I read it out. Because, huh?
Did you just zoom me in as well?
Did I just zoom you in?
Yeah, before when I said it automatically zoomed, was that you as well?
No. What? I didn't do anything. I've not done anything.
You touched my mouse just a second ago to zoom me in to read that text.
I didn't do anything, I promise. I might have zoomed you in to read the text.
Did you?
Yeah.
The first time as well?
No. Only the last time.
Yeah, because I knew the last time, but I thought you did it from... See!
Let's see, my hands are here, above the table.
All right, it stopped. I think this is the normal zoom.
That looks acceptable.
It does, isn't it?
Very good, Shiva. You have...
I'll allow it. Thank God. All right. I have texted the production, and they are aware of the issue. But... apparently there's no fix.
Oh, well. We'll have to deal with it then.
Yes, we shall deal with it. And as long as you guys can hear us, that's the most important thing for us. So, let us know. If you cannot hear us, then we'll demand an instant fix. But I think you can hear us.
Instant fix. We demand an instant fix.
Yeah, oh, let us know also if you can't hear the game sound. Nice ward being placed, but that was a smooth ward, so that means that first ward didn't scout out the other ward being placed.
Sneaky,
sneaky.
It is
gonna get fixed, you guys. Production is in the house. Rub, save us from the sun, from the mute. Something is muted.
Nothing has changed yet. Something has changed.
30 yeah. seconds
I
to battle.
I do love mysteries like this. Oh, battle for the bottom rune.
Yeah, let's see if this one is going to live or die. Oh, Beastmaster is going to live or die. Sexy Bamboo is going to give him the whole run around. Flock didn't really work out, so they'll just take the rune and back off.
They still secure it for themselves, though. This might be triple rune, unless... unless the Bean Boys want to go and actually play aggressive, they've got Shikuchi on Weaver available if they want to just sprint across to that safe lane Dire rune. Yeah, that's what they're doing. So it's going to be the 2-for-2 anyway. Even with the aggressive movement.
Should be, and there's already there, the sentry ward's already there, so they got this. They got this.
What have we here?
A golden thread.
I was meant to have this.
Easy lemon squeeze.
I heard something very faintly just then.
I heard nothing.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I just heard Morana pick up a bounty rune very, very faintly. But I don't know.
Right, so this phase's void is on the offlane. Double G will play that, and that means that we have two heavily roaming supports. I mean, having a Morana mid, having a clean safe lane means that they don't necessarily need supports to help them out. Giving more freedom to the Morana, although...
Nyx and Earth Spirit roaming, though? I guess they've got, like, rolling balls. There's no Orb of Venom. Like, if they had Orb of Venom on Earth Spirit, I could at least understand. They roll, they slow, they stun from Nyx. Yeah.
Maybe Nyx is going to stick around top. I mean, they don't really need a range support, but why would you have a Nyx? First of all, Nyx Assassin is not often played as support. Purely for the reason that he does not offer a lot of safety for anybody in the early stage of the game. He can fail once and then... all he can do is try and run you down, which, you know, he won't be able to do so.
Apparently we are also relatively quiet.
Also, we
like
are relatively
5 minutes ago.
Quiet 5 minutes ago.
But I don't know if that's Twitch chat being Twitch chat or them being resourceful and helpful.
I want to say that they're always resourceful. Ooh, boogie lift! He's fine, the lift is up there. That's going to be a not-so-fine Earth Spirit, though. That is a huge celery. You can't just say today in Rubik.
What is
the bug?
Any help also this Weaver? Yeah, Weaver gets the bug. There you go. 2-0.
Roaming combo not working out too well. We'll try again, though. Does he have?
Round 2, he doesn't have any mana, and you might be able to just break him down.
The Orb of Venom. Finally, Earth Spirit has the Orb of Venom.
Yeah. Well, he had it also. He fought it at the Secret Shop. He had it also when he tried to run the Ogre Major, but that's the Ogre Major. All the heroes are going to try and kill him.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They need them in the middle lane. OD is sitting on 5-for-2, Murano 7-for-2. So, I would say fairly
Selfish.
Even for now. We'll see how it ends up. As I feel like it should be slightly OD favored.
It's mainly thanks to the arrow from Nisha. You know, you throw it onto the range creep, you're able to kind of control equilibrium with the lane and also get free CS through it. While OD kind of has to, you know, right click creeps, hit Astral, try and force the Murano back, and there's so much more nuance to his laning stage than the kind of point and click Murano that you throw into there.
Trying. Celery has an Invis rune and he knows that there's a sentry around. If he walks up the high ground, they know. Yep. There you go. Impale's there. We live is the question. I don't think he can. Or maybe he can. Maybe he cannot. He cannot.
You definitely cannot.
I was really hopeful there for a second. I thought maybe they have it, and then...
It was close. I mean, even the Klinks nearly dies. Forced to pop the salve and run himself around.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised because I think they knew that there was a sentry there. And we already saw him being very, very careful when he was walking up high ground. Started out well with getting two kills, but ever since then, he's been losing heroes and exotic deer. He's having a great time because even though Seema is dead, he doesn't care. He gets kills. He's been part of all three kills so far. I don't know if that's smart. First Spirit just denied himself to neutral. That's going to be a while before he's back up.
Yeah, they had no shrine, so I think it's okay. He spent all his money. Is Rupert just going to die again, actually? Heads back into the trees. But yeah, that one sentry ward from the Dire is paying off dividends massively for them, getting a number of kills and placed so aggressively in the lane that it kind of cuts off Weaver's retreat, right? Because as a Weaver, you don't want to Shikuchi east or west. You want to go straight towards your tower. But with that down, he kind of has to divert his path and obviously puts himself in even more danger with these mobile heroes like the Earth Spirit.
So, in the meantime, there's
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
How do you feel this lane should turn out? It's very even right now, like, it's 19 kills, 19 assets on both.
I think Beastmaster should have Swelling Blade and make this lane easier for himself just from the last hit perspective. So he's got such great base damage, right? 74 base damage against a 75 of Void. You add in that Swelling Blade and you're going to be matching him. Not doing better with the boars added on top of that.
Haste!
Well, they're running an aggressive tri lane to try and get more farm on the Weaver and also protest things from. But at this point, it's not really working out as a which one just catches the OD. And Astral himself with the arrow, perhaps. But regardless, an aggressive tri lane is not working out so far for Bean Boys, and, well, they're not really winning any of their lanes.
I think Cancel's doing okay mid. You know, sure enough, he dies to that Morana, and it's not nice, as we do have wonderful, wonderful audio.
It's all so clearly now.
I can hear things happening.
Oh, this is fine.
I think that's perfect.
Yeah, we're good.
Thank you, Rob. Whatever you did.
This is great. All right.
Oh yeah, I think now Beastmaster's level 6, they can maybe look to TP him in or smoke to a lane, find a kill, and swing the balance a little bit in another one of these lanes, because OD has a lot of damage behind him with level 3 Astral. If they can roar up, do damage to Nisha, and then Astral as the kind of killing blow before she leaps away or as she's leaping away, it's definitely a big kill for them to have. Other option is just to wait for Bambo to actually get his Necro books and then look to rotate, or at least Necro 1.
They're going again here on top. They want to try and get this Ogre Magi. But Ogre Magi is kind of took a munch. Klinks ends up dropping. Kasvor taking a lot of damage here and will drop as well. Weaver gets a double kill on their spirit. The only soul survivors.
Well.
Comeback time.
Suddenly Bloodlust Weaver even holds on to 10 stick charges and finds a couple of kills.
Yep.
But this is again where the... Not the fault, but the weakness lies with the Nyx and Earth Spirit, right? They've been relatively good aggressively when they're the ones rolling in and choosing when to fight.
Yeah.
But if they are initiated on or if they're caught out, they don't have any saving mechanisms. They just roll away on Earth Spirit and try and outrun their opponents. Whereas
But
Nyx,
they can't save the Klinks.
Yeah. Klinks just has to kind of, you know, invis and hope to run.
Yeah, and then you got the Stinkle detection and all of a sudden it's a lot more difficult than what it was before. But if you're saying like they have to wait for Beastmaster for level 6 and then get some kills with that, surely that goes the same for the Faceless Void. He's level 6, he's got his Chronosphere. During the draft he talks about heroes that would do damage during the Chronosphere, and then you got yourself a Morana, again land a nice arrow, wait a second. The top lane indeed, Celery, does what he can before he dies, he will die, and let's see if he's set up enough for the kill on Exotic Deer, doesn't seem to be so.
I think they have to match each other, right? Like if Bambo stays here, the Void has to stay there. Void stays, the Beastmaster stays, you know?
And then it's all about who has the better impact. And that is all about who has the better vision. And that should be in the hands of Beastmaster.
With the Hawk, yeah, that's true. That's true. They're actually looking to potentially rotate the Morana down with this first Chrono, kill off that Beastmaster,
Dyer's
and give the Void an even better laning stage for the next couple of minutes.
Sure.
Because even though, you know, Necro or Blink or whatever on the Beastmaster is good, I think Void with items is even better.
Yes.
There's the arrow. The leap kind of halted slightly by The Chrono's Chamber is also magic.
Elspeth rolls into victory just to make sure.
Yep, just in case. Cancel, teleported in. Wasted his teleport. So that's gonna be Mirana back to the mid lane, knowing that she can save for Lizabel by herself. Gets the lucky rune as well. Illusion rune for her.
Double bounty rune for the Earth Spirit, just casually walks up before the even minute mark and picks up two in a row.
Pre-planned.
Clever.
I don't know if pre-planned is a thing, but something planned is already planned.
What about pre-planned?
Illusion.
No, but that's not a thing, because something planned is already thought out before. So planned is already in before, so if you're pre-planning something, that means you're not actually, oh, holy, you're dead. Very dead.
You European people take the English language far too literally.
It's a curse and a blessing. Is there detection? Yes, there
oh,
is.
Oh, yes.
That's a dead Mirana. That's a Star Sword. That doesn't matter. That's
great. Got hit by the jump as well. He's got roll TP.
Yes.
He could have got chased down there.
Weaver. But has got his ult available. Might need it. Has got an impale. There's a mana burn. It was a mana burn up on the assassin. So that would have been a problem for the ult, but he does have stick charges still. We saw earlier how important they can be.
And Beastmaster just holding his own on bottom lane, forcing Double G to use stick charges with double boar now. If he's able to take the void like half HP, might be able to kill him with one roar. So he's got level 2 wild axes. He's actually gone for a 2-3-2 build, which I feel is relatively uncommon. We've seen a few players like max axes.
Yeah.
But usually it's against like a Broodmother or you know something like that, or if they have to jungle. Going for a couple of points of Wild Axes definitely gives them a lot of damage in the early game. Especially like instant nuke damage if you want to finish a void before he time walks. Rubik's 6, and unfortunately he steals a Rolling Boulder. It's like the most useless... Actually, Earth Spirit is like the most useless hero to steal from.
Oh yeah, you kind of need a combination of his spells to make him useful.
You need the
stones.
You need the stones, yeah. Maybe he can use the... Hope the Earth Spirit drops a stone in front of him. He can just use that instead.
That could actually work out. So scan used by the Radiant. They know this Face of Void is by
Radiant's
himself.
Top tower is under
it's
attack.
Still a Face of Void though. Let's see. Roar comes out. In comes a stun as well. Trying to hold him down permanently. And a lift. Perfect.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And they do lose the OD in mid because...
Yeah.
Well, why? Why do they continuously lose this OD?
I don't know, I didn't see it, but I believe he got arrowed.
But he shouldn't get arrowed.
That's so simple, Shiva.
That sounds so simple.
I actually don't know what happened there.
No, I wasn't there with my camera either, because you don't expect an OD to die like that. There was an Earth Spirit around him, so that's fair enough, but...
I mean, potentially what happens is that Cancel uses his Astral on the creep wave to try and CS, and then Nyx comes in, Carapace next to the Astral, then stun, then arrow, you know, they can chain that quite nicely.
Oh yeah, it wasn't Earth Spirit, it was Nyx Assassin indeed. Okay, let's see. Arrow hits him on the Ogre Manti, but there is a Bandle around to offer him some protection. The roll's still in, there's ults available, so everyone's got Moonlight Shadow, where's the protection? They don't want to use it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
They can't see the Boogie Ogre.
Well, they didn't have any dust, I guess, because that was a Rubik Moonlight Shadow. See, he did steal useful things.
See, who expects that?
Yeah, why didn't the supports carry detection?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It can't be hard to know what Rubik's
this
stolen.
This Glings really wants the last hit on the tower.
He's got it as well. Oh no, the glyph! The glyph!
Got him!
15 HP. Oh, now you play the mind games. Oh!
Oh, nice deny. Sing
Sing.
Got it, and he's going for the kill now as well. He's got some help. The dust is there as well. Exotic Deer, you stuck around too
long. Oh, buddy.
Long. That's not gonna happen. No matter how much this Earth Spirit is trying, that. Lynx is dead. There was a lot of people.
They're all here.
Yeah, they're all here. He wants to try and go for this Ogre Magi, but again, not gonna happen. Sing Sing still there as well. It's been going mana, but it doesn't matter.
Oh boy.
You losing. Come to try to take our Weaver?
Losing your safe laner and your mid laner in quick succession.
For what? Is under attack.
For a deny on a tower, Shiva. He nearly got the tier one.
Yeah, but he didn't. That is some good play though. That was good. That was needed also. They were kind of letting things out of control. If we look at the net worth, it's now very even. Among the top four, if you will. Top six even.
Sakaar, all very close. Except Cancel.
Cancel had such...
He's got Midas, though. It's all fine. He's got Hand of Midas.
I've been... During the draft, I said, okay, you know what? Cancel... Some people call it Sing Sing Stack.
We praised him too much.
And then there he goes. Gets arrowed.
We've ruined his life by singing his praise.
We basically made him a magnet.
Oh, God, yeah. An arrow magnet, literally.
Yep.
Oh, wait, I'm not allowed to use that word.
Why not?
Malini gets sad when I say the L word.
Literally?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
I don't know. He doesn't. He gets like mega triggered by that word for some reason. It's because people use literally figuratively.
They do use literally for literally everything.
Literally, yep. Literally everything.
Not even possible. Like, he's literally dead. No, he's not.
He's literally hitting creeps.
He's literally, like, that's true. You can use Dyer's it for that.
But he's not, though. He's standing still.
Well, I don't know who you have targeted. I was looking at someone who was literally hitting creeps. All right.
We need to stop.
Yes. All right. Push on of bottom tier 2 tower. Is this going to be something that alternate attacks is going to... defend, it looks like they want to. They do have a Chronosphere.
They need that Mirana here, though.
Links. The roar on the face is void again. Is there a good... No, there's not. There's no dead face void. There's a Chronosphere. Hits him on two. And, should be dead.
Mirana might catch more here. Face boots, arrow ready.
Dyer's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, hunting Rubik.
Yeah, Rubik is the only one that she would get. Oh, what?
Launch arrow, miss arrow.
Yeah.
Nisha, what have you had to store?
Ooh, launch arrow, celery. Let's see what you can do. Please don't farm creeps with the arrow.
No, definitely farm creeps with the arrow.
Dyer's
please hit enemies with arrow.
Level 1 arrow is for hitting creeps, not for hitting heroes.
No, astral into things. Oh, it's like he also played Rala sometimes.
Dyer's middle tower.
I like
attack.
It.
That's not a legal use of level 1 arrow.
I like it. It's good.
They've been disqualified from the key of major qualifications.
It's the ultimate, like, in your face, your own arrow.
Taste of your own medicine.
Taste of your own medicine. She'd have seen it coming. Tried to hunt me down.
That's a good way for Cancel to get back into the game.
It is. It really needs that. Look at this net worth.
It just jumped up to second place.
That's crazy. That's really good for him too. He has got the Midas as well, so he can catch up there and experience a bit as well. I mean, in terms of levels, he is the highest level in the game right now, which is really good. And he's at the higher levels there. And Core Staff is done, so the beginning of Hurricane Pike.
He's getting there.
He
slowly,
will get there.
But surely.
And it is also almost time for Weaver to finish up his Desolator. So far, Bean Boys are actually not looking too bad. They had a bit of a rough stage during the laning stage, but I would say that come mid-game, which is where, you know, we are, I don't know where to watch. Rubik dies, but in the meantime, we also have got a Beastmaster getting ganked.
Dyer's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, okay. They're ganking him all right. He's trying to do anything he can to get the chest silent. He's making attacks. But he still has the regenerate when he gets back up.
I would have thought that Bean Boys would come down and defend this. They know Chrono's on cooldown. They've spotted it, you know, a couple of heroes elsewhere on the map, so there's only three down there at the bottom lane for the tier one. But they decide instead to trade tier one top, get a bit of damage on to mid lane, hold Mirana there as well, and get farm on the cancel instead of.
Rubik, you just died mid. You literally just died mid. I can say it then, right? Oh, Rubik. Doing a lot of damage. Wants to try and help out to kill the Earth Spirit, and it looks like that might just be happening right now. Nope, not gonna happen. In comes arrow upon arrow. Nice Astral, saving the life of the Ogre Magi for just a little while longer, so he can get an extra stun up. Gets it on the Nyx Assassin. Nyx Assassin, right care if it's but the bug! The actual bug still kills him off. He is the only one that dies here so far. There's a full shrine. Mirana's ready. There's a second one there as well. The arrow misses because the Astral is there. A bit miscommunication there, but it should still be enough. The lift is in time. No Chrono because why would he Chrono? He doesn't have any follow-up damage. He's just a Phaser's Void.
No, not just there. I'm looking at this fight and wondering why two specific players are being so timid. Cancel, I can kind of understand.
That's a Chrono. Where is the backup? In comes the kick. Up on three. Ogre Magi. Moonlight Shadow that was stolen by Celery gets used. Is there protection this time? Yes, there is. The sentry is down. Bambo has already picked up.
Two shots.
Second, that's four people dead. Exotic there. A double damage room.
DD clinks with a Desolator as well. That's not fun to fight into.
That is so much damage.
Yeah, the whole start of this sequence of events was kind of weird. Cancel did this kind of shimmy back and forth where he didn't want to engage, ran himself back, astral the save. Then when the Radiant kind of move across towards this shrine, there were a number of instances where Void could potentially have, you know, got some big chronos, helped out by Mirana and Clix, but I feel like alternate attacks kind of half made a call to retreat and half made a call to go in, which is why Mirana wanted to get some damage done, just to start the fight and set things up for them. But Clix seemed pretty intent on telling the Void to wait until he was ready to fight.
Yeah.
In the end, it worked out decently.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was the right call, because that was... That was a great chrono, and then her spirit waited with the kick until the right time so that he could get the kick on the Ogre Magi there as well. So Ogre Magi couldn't even help with people that were stuck in the chrono sphere. And then everybody just ends up dead. Moonlight Shadow or no. A lot of slows coming out there on the Nick Assassin, but Beastmaster still will die. But Payback is here. Weaver is here. The Dust is there as well. Can they catch the Clink is the question. Not if it's up to this Earth Spirit, but it doesn't matter what Earth Spirit says, because he will not be able to save his four and will drop and join him in the grave. Can they find Mirana? I don't think so.
Dyer's
Chaos Leap available as well, 17 sick charges, and Void is just, he ran out.
Yeah, well, I mean, all of a sudden, with no Moonlight Shadow and no Chrono, this alternate attacks team decided to try and fight 5v5 and against the kind of superior mobility of the Bean Boys with four stamp and Shikuchi.
Everybody was just there all of a sudden. The shrine there teleports.
Everyone follow Bambo. He's going in. You follow him, man.
Dyer's middle tower. This is true.
And now he's got Necro level 2. He'll soon have 3 plus Quick. Dyer's middle
tower has
fallen. I'm sure there's lots of people. I would definitely follow Bambo into battle, though.
I mean, that for me is a little bit more questionable.
Why? Because he's like a Dutch Napoleon.
But it's very hit and miss.
I don't care.
And I know it's very cliche to say, but
he's got the charisma to, you know, gather and lead the people. It doesn't matter where he goes or where he takes you.
You don't think Sing Sing has that?
Not as much as Bambo. Oh. I don't know. Bambo just has this kind of.
They both okay. You know how they both talk. Both will say, "Let's just go."
Just fucking go in.
Yeah. Just fight.
Why are you pussy? Stop farm!
And they both say the same things, you know? They both would use the same
words.
Are
they the same person? Is this what you're...
They're not the same
person. Is this what you're getting to now, Shiva?
Definitely not the same person. Because obviously you also think that one is more... lead worthy. Has more leadership qualities. Oh, Boogie. Well, he tanked the gank. Oh, and he dodged this! Oh my god, he dodged...
Is he tanking enough?
Is he gonna live? Where's his team? Where's Astro? He lives!
Wow.
Okay, that's on Link's Assassin.
Oh, the Mirana illusion might kill him, Shiva. No, never mind.
What? Don't panic. But that was on Kessori. He missed his impale.
Oh, yeah.
And it was an awkward impale at that.
And it's not a small target to hit either. Ogre is a big lad.
And it was like in a small area. Like, where else is he going to go apart from that way? But he hit it like that. So it's like,
oh. He was expecting the teleportation. Suddenly glitches over the cliff. Now it's time for alternate attacks to make a move forward. They've got Blink, Chrono, Vlad's on Void. Roshan is up and ready to go.
Well, they already tried just now. Spy Carapace, they find a Rubik. Nice lift, but Rubik's still dead. Oh, there's so much damage on this Clink. And that's a Chrono. That's another kill. That's Beastmaster if they can get it. Where's the follow-up? Is there any follow-up? Beastmaster will still end up dropping, though. Even without Weaver to be there, the rest of the team trying to come in to help. Exotic Deer trying to go on the Ogre Magic gets put under. There's the Hurricane Pike, but it's not going to do any good right now. Ogre still drops, and the Weaver and the OD are the last ones standing, and I'm not sure if OD is going to stand for very much longer because Cancel is, he's getting under attack. Weaver lives. But that was what they were trying to achieve with that first smoke. I didn't need any smoke. Just run at them. And they have nice wards there too. Under attack. Did they just place them, or no, they were already there.
They were already there. I just don't know why you'd go into that fight 3v5. Like, you've lost.
You've lost your Rubik. There's a Chronosphere on
the
Beastmaster.
You've lost two. Two are dead.
Yeah, well, they didn't know Beastmaster was dead. They were going to try to help the Beastmaster. Because Beastmaster didn't die in the Chronosphere. He died afterwards.
I still don't think it's worth, like, diving into this area where you've got limited vision.
Yeah.
But regardless, now, again, it's the situation where Chrono's on cooldown. Alternate attacks have to be kind of wary of their step, make sure that they're not giving away any free kills. And don't rush into a 5v5 team fight. You know, Beastmaster has Roar and Necro 3. He's actually popped his Necro 3 to D ward, interestingly enough. Just clearing through observers and sentries. It's like a minefield in here.
Yeah, he did miss one sentry. Boogie?
Bye, Boogie.
Carol.
Yeah, that Klinks has another DD, Shiva.
How does he find these devils?
I don't know.
I mean, if you compare Weaver and Klinks, I normally find them fairly similar heroes. Their item build is often very similar. They're both invis, they're both sneaky, they both want to weave in and out of fights to try and get the right positioning and pick up the people at the back lines. And normally I find that Weaver comes out ahead because he's got padlocks.
Yeah.
He's more elusive than the Klinks.
This Klinks is steroids,
but this
though.
This Klinks is mad.
He's like finding DDs, he's got a bunch of HP out of his death pact, and he's got this Chrono.
Hello! They found one! The Roar is there! Spike Carapace is doing a lot of work.
But they can't
though.
See him anymore. That was their only sentry, right?
Oh,
no, they had dust. They had
but
dust.
They, they didn't have dust. He used his hit against the He just walked out.
But I mean, like, they had dust in case he tried to run away.
I guess so. Yes. Radiant structures are fortified. So they got one kill. They pushed the tower. Should be able to take it out. But they are losing their own tower as well in the bottom lane. And their mid lane tier 2 tower is getting pressured as well by this Mirana. And Ogre can't really do anything against it better yet. Ogre? Dire's Boogie? Top tower.
Chronosphere is up again.
You should be very careful.
If the Bean Boys TP back to defend this tier 2, they're going Shrine and tier. They're TPing back en masse. This could be nasty for them. A big Chrono with both Klinks and Mirana in the vicinity to deal out this big damage. I've left Bambo up the top, but he's got TP and his Necro 3 ready. Like, he needs to be in this fight.
This Ogre is so bold.
He's got Solar Crest, so he's not too scared about the right big damage coming out.
They get the tower back off. I mean, that's still really good to get. Beastmaster doesn't get anything and just teleports out. I think he was waiting for a fight to start and would have taken maybe tier 3 tower if he could.
Yeah, just lurking around waiting for the opportunity.
Yeah.
This map has opened up massively for Alternate. Top tower is
under attack. Yeah, they're looking good.
They're sprinting forwards. Like, the Radiant need a gem or a million sentries because there's Nyx and Klinks just sprinting around the map doing whatever the hell they want, and Celery might get popped here.
Has to be careful.
Finds the safety of his teammates. OD's nearby now, and
I'm not sure how safe he is in full vision, though.
Well, Cancel's got Blink, Hurricane Pike, and Astral to potentially save one or two teammates, if not himself.
I feel like he needs to save it for himself.
That's big. Blink Beastmaster ready.
Mirana also Medusa, but there is a sentry on the cliff, so Celery did see him walking up there. That's just so much damage.
Two hits to half HP, and they are looping in behind.
They are. Smoke used. Do they have a dust?
They've
yes,
got
they
dust
do.
On Beastmaster.
They've got dust on Beastmaster. There it is. There's the sentry. That's already. Woo! Nice Chronosphere up on 3. Rubick still gets at least a stun up. They still get both of their disables up. That's very nice. And the Roar as well. Council just looking for a way into this fight. A very messy fight. But they take out the Aegis, and it is Beam Boys that are coming out ahead. Can they take down Klinks for the second time? Mirana. Already not in this fight, it seems.
OD rejoins. Oh, hello.
Be careful, please. He can actually drop very fast if he's not careful, but so can Klinks. How did that fight turn around so fast? Where was Mirana?
I mean, it's decent Chrono, but when you're trying to chase down an OD and an Ogre when you've got a Chrono on 3 on the back end, you need to focus your energy onto, you know, one target or two targets in the Chrono to kill them. But if you're splitting all of this damage across them, and Earthspirit and Nyx are kind of running around trying to create chaos in the back, Dire's middle tower. Sure enough, Weaver did fly back and time-lapse into the fight again, so added an extra body into it, but I still think that should have been a clean sweep for attacks. Has fallen.
Well, worthy buyback, that's for sure. Set in stone. Because you were earlier saying how much the map was opening up for alternate attacks, and with that tier 2 tower mid down,
they finally get across the river.
Has got some more map control as well, Still, though, observer wards are low for both teams.
They've got a couple on Celery, and he's also very close to his Blink Dagger, so I feel like someone else has to pick up the slack there. And actually, Boogie has 2,000 gold and a bounty rune. Mine! He's got Lamp lined up, but I wonder if something like the Force Staffer himself wouldn't be too bad.
I mean, with all the movement that his team, or his enemy team has, it's probably really good to have some for himself as well.
Full Vlads.
Well, he can always go for movement later on. He just wants to be the tanky one, which I don't blame him for either.
Just, if tanky, get tankier.
Yeah. If he gets caught in the Chronosphere, he's not going to die during it. Or he's going to, at least, if they're going to focus on him during the Chronosphere, that's going to be bad. Let's see if this Rubick can get away from this one. It looks like he cannot. He should not. There you go. I was going to say, he lived for a very long time there.
Stays alive to get a final Fade Bolt out.
Worth.
Definitely worth.
As we'll delay the push a little bit. In the meantime, top lane is getting pressured as well. We do have a teleport up on the OD, who just got it from his backpack.
A bloodlusted tower, though. Oh god, look at that. Mirana and Klinx both wailing into that tier 3. And now finally the strafe is popped. There's no glyph for another, what, 20 seconds?
Yeah, that's a dead tier 3. Now they can go on the shrines or just go high ground.
Good Hurricane Pike. The blink forward.
Chronosphere has both of the cores in there. Can they take out one? Yes, they can. In the meantime, Bambo tries to do what he can. He just jumps in there, being the meat shield for his OD, but he's not able to be that. And he dies. They do get the Klinks. Can they get more? They bob back the OD. They look for the chase. Nice Sanity's Eclipse. It's not enough to kill off Nisha, though, who leaps away but still has a bug on him, so they still know where he is. Can they chase it? They do have a 4-staff in 3
into the
seconds.
Creep wave.
And the 4-staff. Yes, that's a kill right there.
Just like accepting your fate. I will farm this creep wave before I die. I mean, buyback on OD. The ward placed on high ground gets spotted. They get the tier 3, but no real big damage onto Rax or any further buildings.
But they can take down the shrines, which was very important for Beam Boys to get the teleports.
Especially when Roshan is potentially spawning in the next minute or two.
And they don't get anything off the back of it, or unless they want to try to force out the buyback on the Mirana or on the Klinks.
They do push very fast. You know, we looked at their attack speed between Bloodlust and Inner Beast over on this OD and the Weaver, and with Vlads up on Ogre. Sing Sing's not struggling with his HP regen or anything like that, so it could just be a tier 3 for a tier 3. Dire's middle tower. Like, I don't think Mirana definitely does not want to buy back, and especially once that timer hits like 20 or sub 20 seconds, it's almost inevitable that you do not buy back.
But you can't really see Tigrone. It's just not going to happen. But they accept that and they move back.
Yeah, if they had their Necro books, I could probably do it, but 15 seconds until that's up and running. And it will be 2 minutes until Roche spawns.
Long Roche timer. What do you think that favors more? I mean, Beam Boys have already bought back on the OD. It gives them some more time to get his back right.
I think it's pretty shit for both teams. Okay. Like, in the immediate, it's worse for alternate attacks, because obviously they've just respawned, they didn't buy back, they could have gone into Roche and taken Aegis and potentially finished the game. So maybe now I've said that out loud, it's worse for Dire.
Oh, the Chronosphere again on cancel. He is getting targeted so hard.
Die back as well.
And indeed, cannot buy back this time. Beastmaster's trying to push out top lane as fast as he can, but I think even Bambo realizes that he's got to come back, and the ward actually still stands. It's outside of range of the sentry. So the vision is full there. There you go. They jump in. They go on the clean. Silas is there. No time for a relapse, for a time lapse at all. Boogie, that's what you get. He is so tanky, but he's just not able to do anything. He's not a carry. He doesn't do any damage. Bambo comes in. He's trying to turn this around, but he's out of damage. He's out of mana. He managed to kill off one, but he does end up dropping. Nyx Assassin now chasing down Celery. Celery has got that gem. Doesn't want to die. Still has a shrine available, or used it just now.
They haven't killed Rax here, Shiva.
They have not killed Rax. It is buying time. They're just throwing bodies at it.
They're buying back the Klinks and TPing in as well.
Why would they do that?
I mean, Weaver and OD don't have buyback, right? They're still on cooldown. So they know that there's no chance that for 30 and 50 seconds respectively, there'll be no OD or Weaver. So in this time, they can take potentially bot racks with the help of Klinks. Now
they
he's bought back.
As well. They'll go in. Arrows flying. Radiant structures. There goes a fortify again. They have one.
And then after all this is said and done, Roshan's alive.
And now it's perfect for alternate attacks.
Yep. So I take back what I said earlier.
They back off now, though. They don't even take the last bit of the range racks.
I don't think it's worth it. Range racks is relatively meaningless in this. They've taken two lanes of melee racks, plus the one ranged mid.
All of drawings on the mini map.
Oh, yeah.
Council's just drawing an arrow man like go.
Like they don't have they don't have a split pusher, right? There's no like Tinker or Invoke or anything like that that can clear wave and then TP into the fight to help the team.
Yeah.
They have to be five and they have to go as five wherever they're going, whether it be Roshan, whether it be moving towards the mid lane to take tier three.
Yeah.
And now they've scattered it with Hawk. You know that the big man's up. Wait, hang on, what? How does the Hawk just randomly aggro an ancient creep?
I do not know.
That's a bit bad. That's a good arrow, though.
Very nice arrow up on the Rubick. Nice kick as well. Miranda ultimate being used just because.
Oh, that perfect.
And the Chronosphere still clips Cancel. They get the Weaver. No buyback on him. Can Cancel finally do some damage in a fight? It doesn't look like it. The Roar comes out in the Clink. Maybe they can get a dieback on him, but even Bambo cannot finish. Exotic Deer goes for the Ethereal Blade. He just runs out, or Ghost Scepter rather. Not as rich as having an ethereal knight, but he will end up dropping three down on the side of Bean Boys. That means Roshan is free to take for ultimate attacks, and well, it's not just going to be an agent, I fear.
They still have to go through tier 2 top, unless they shove mid and go for like tier 4, some weird play like that. I don't think it's... Maybe it's worth the Clinks just going invis and finishing off ranged ranks bot lane, because there's no glyph, and that's just like, what, 4 hits or something from the Clinks to finish? That racks down a bot. Relatively simple takedown.
Yeah.
It'll be the smooth and simple, go down top, take tier 2, siege high ground, try and win another team fight with Chrono available now.
Or just COD.
And Chrono him.
Walk in, Chrono him.
Oh, he's not
kill
just
him.
Yet.
I was going to say, kill him was part of the plan. There was a shrine available as well, nicely from Celery, just because. All right.
They needed like a smidgen more damage onto the OD, and that was game over, right?
And because they did that, they are going to, or rather, Bean Boys is going to live another day because they can't pressure the tier 3 top tower.
Like, OD's buyback was still on the cooldown for another minute and a half.
That would have been game if they got him. I mean, it's worth it going for it.
Outside of any like monumental cock-ups by the Dire team, that would have been game over in a perfect world.
I mean, it's still Dota. Anything could happen.
Anything can happen.
They could die fountains before they get mega creeps and then all die.
That's a possibility, Shiva.
That is a possibility.
That
in
is
this
a
game
distinct possibility.
Yes. Thank you for recognizing.
Well,
my analytical skills.
Yeah, you're welcome. It's fine. Finally get to kill off some shrines.
Extra gold.
And
always
then use one of their own.
Why not? It's faster than going back to fountain. They can just re-engage. Go bottom. Take out that range racks.
This Aghanim's on Void is so huge. Having that reduced cooldown, like 60 seconds, just pumping these chronos out, regardless of where you are, what you're doing. It's like, right, I see a target. Do I have Clinks and or Mirana near me? Let's go.
I mean, even the fights last sometimes a minute, so you might, you know, there's a small chance
chrono.
You can use it a second chrono in a fight. Or shrine and go shrine back in. Why is my camera not moving? There you go, Chronosphere. That's a save for a little bit. Let's see, that's gonna save Bambo long enough, though. Buyback on Rubick as he just did die. Oh, a lot of damage being done to the Nyx Assassin. He's still one, but this BKB on this Clinks, he could have focused the racks and taken it, but he doesn't do that. They just end up backing off.
So Sing Sing has Ags on Weaver, and he used it on the Beastmaster to take Beastmaster from 300 HP to 300 HP.
He was in Chrono
for so long, then Astral, and he tried to use the Weaver ulti on him, but didn't actually heal him or anything.
That's unfortunate, because that could be, like, this is definitely an item that could win them the game.
That's a game changer.
I think it's a game changer for sure.
Especially if they can like get it onto Cancel. Like if Cancel, you know, starts hitting people, stealing in,
yep.
Drops low, gets chronoed, you take him back outside of a chrono.
Well, you can't time-lapse people out of chrono, you gotta wait until it's done, right? Or not?
I'm not sure, actually. I feel like you should be able to time-lapse out of chrono. I mean, like, time-lapse other people out of chrono.
But chrono is a time... lock.
Can we break time? Can Weaver break time?
It's like there's... Basically, time stands still in the Chronosphere. So,
but time lapse. Time lapse is where time breaks.
Yeah,
right?
But there's no time in the Chronosphere, so you cannot break time if there's no time.
I need an adult. Can you time lapse out of Chrono? No, not Chrono Trigger. I don't want that. Oh, this is
No. Wait a second. Team fight happening. Moonlight Shadow coming in. Instant Blink forward. Oh, I'm not sure what Nyx Assassin was doing, but there's a Chronos Bear. It's on the Mighty Ogre. Vero on the Mighty Ogre as well. In the meantime, Beastmaster is taking a lot of damage. Where is that timeless we needed? There it was. It does a lot, though. It might just be enough.
Sammy's Eclipse is ready. Drop the hammer.
Ooh, that did a lot of damage. It's time for the cleanup crew to come in. That is what is happening here. Three already dead. They are looking for the forest.
Look at Klinx.
Look at Klinx.
You know where he is.
Look at Klinx. They know where he is. Look at
Klinx. This is...
What? There he is. Exotic Deer. Okay, you know what? It's
there we go.
Comic value.
56 stolen intelligence on cancel.
And that is why that item is a game changer.
Yeah?
It was also a little bit of a botched chrono, though. He only had the Ogre Magi, and we already talked about this. He is basically
that wasn't good.
Tank.
That wasn't good at all.
Yeah, what did your Google search
I had to go and look at the team fight, you know?
Yeah.
Also, I can't be bothered to search for this anymore.
Alright, that's fine. This game is needing your attention anyway, because let's see how much of a game changer the Aghanim's Weaver actually is.
Oh, it's forcing buybacks galore here.
Yeah, it's forcing the fortification as well. Cancel still standing on the high ground. Weaver has to be careful. There is a Chronosphere available again, and right now they're able to be in the Chronosphere, both of them.
The trouble is, you can't Chrono and then buy back Klinx. You have to like buy back Klinx, TP, and then Chrono.
Yes.
So as long as Klinx hasn't bought back, Team Bean knows that they're free to take this full lane of racks.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have got ourselves a comeback.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
How big's the swing, actually? From like 17k to probably around 7k.
That's massive, though.
XP swing is like back down to zero.
Yeah, that's massive. I like I like that one item can do that. But that's just only possible in Dota 2.
Aghanim's Weaver. Creator of swings.
Definitely.
But again, they've got no real great hero to deal with the lanes pushing into them.
Yeah.
So that feels like maybe a one-off after winning a team fight. But if they can string a couple of good team fights together and take another lane of racks, maybe take the next Roshan.
The only trouble comes when... The only way they can take team fights is when alternate attacks actually pushes into their base.
Hmm.
Because other than that, alternate attacks is not going to get caught out.
You basically have to force the Chrono onto someone that you don't mind losing.
Yes, so or like someone that Weaver can hopefully time-lapse after. Like that is going to survive through the Chronosphere.
Yeah.
Depending on which of our theories is
correct. Or you astral them and then time-lapse them and make them die anyway.
Yeah, but Cancel's normally the target.
That's true. They do like jumping on Cancel.
They do. They do like jumping on Beastmaster as well. Or rather, Sexy Bembo likes jumping on them.
And he just blinks into the middle of like five of them.
Yes. Imagine if Ogre did that. He's a lot more tanky than the Beastmaster.
But what does Ogre do?
He just stuns and ignites and then is just, look at me, I have two heads.
But Bambo does it because he has boars and necro units. And
yeah, okay.
And he does damage, Shiva. Ogre does
but
it because he's fat and likes being poked by bad people.
Look at how much armor Ogre has. He's so tanky.
He does have a lot of armor, actually. And that halberd... I mean, there's BKB on Klinx, there's Lincoln's on Murano, but I guess the halberd.
That's
feel
only three armor difference. Or four armor.
Oh, between Beastmaster and.
Yeah, it's
Ogre?
Like 29 and 25. I just checked. And Ogre can also give armor to someone else. I can give it to the Beastmaster as he jumps in.
Yeah.
And then make Beastmaster better. Be the better Beastmaster.
The better Beastmaster. The better Master. I even feel like the halberd from Boogie is just to pop Lincolns and Morana.
That could be.
So you can pop and then roar.
What do you think about Morana's item build going from Yone? Before BKB? Well, I guess he has a Lincolns, so that's good.
But you still need a BKB against OD. Like,
yeah.
Lincolns does nothing to save you against the OD just slamming with the Arcane Orb.
Yeah, but having a BKB and a Lincolns feels so useless.
Yeah.
It's very defensive, and they didn't want to be defensive. They wanted to be aggressive.
Yeah, there's lots of slot redundancy there. So I'm wondering even if, like, a Lotus Orb on one of your supports would be good, but Nyx and Earth Spirit both want mobility items. You know, they've both gone Force Blink. Probably Aghanim's next for the Earth Spirit. After he's got his old Ghost Scepter done. And Nyx obviously wants an Angst of his own. So maybe Lotus Orb can't be fitted in, actually. It's a little bit awkward. They've got double Lincolns. Void and Miranda both have it. Shadows. So they can just put this on the Klinks as he pushes high ground, potentially, and just cycle through them.
Miranda also been used. The sentry is disappearing. Is Celery going to place a new sentry in time, is the question.
No.
Well, it doesn't matter because they just backed off again.
Kill the birdie.
They did see the bird because it just vanished. There you go. But it was very wishful thinking to think that the Roshan would appear right at that moment for the timer end. But this is the unfortunate situation that Bean they're in. They cannot afford to leave the base. They have to try and take that team fight and have like the perfect vision available.
And this is the third Roshan, right? So it's going to be Aegis and Cheese.
Yes, correct.
So it's Aegis, Klinks, and Cheese. Or maybe even Cheese, Klinks, and Aegis, Miranda.
If they would smoke right now, that would be also their last Hail Mary smoke, because they have to know everything perfectly, and they just don't. That's a dire scan, so they were expecting a smoke to come from the side. There's a lot of patience in Bean right now, which is definitely respectable.
It's so easy to just like wander out of your base and farm the bottom creep wave. Like, it's so close.
And it's so triggering. Like, seeing the creep wave pushing in that far is like...
it's right there. It's like arm's reach. You want to... like, it's being pinged. Who's Cancel's pinging it? Like, okay.
This is gold. I gotta go, guys. No. I have to farm this.
At this point, they do have to clear it, though.
Yes. And I can as well. But that's the point. You don't know if you can. Look at how scared he is as well. He's just...
What vision do Radiant have? None. Apart from Hawk? Okay, Hawk sees a couple of people.
Hawk and the creep wave. But that Hawk is... that Hawk is dead. That was the Hawk.
They kicked a boulder at it, they tried to impale it, they time walked and rolled to kill that Hawk.
Dire only has one ward as well, but it's still... Dire has all the lanes pushed out, so they're quite okay.
The four-man roaming squad inside the Radiant base, moving from lane to lane to shove out creep waves.
They have...
Here we go.
The patience has ended.
But this is troublesome. Nyx is going to spot this before they reach any kind of high ground.
They are going to spot Nyx. His smoke already broke. He knows. The panic! The pain! Moonlight Shadow used. The sentry is already down. Can they catch out this Nyx assassin? Yes, they can. They lift him up. Can they take him down? Yes, they can as well. Where's that Chronosphere? It's not going to come. Klinks. Thinking about going on the OD. OD pops the BKB. Chronosphere. The OD is there. BKB and all. Chronosphere did get stolen by Celery. And everybody's just leaving the OD. Everybody's just panicking and getting the hell out of there. Double G dies, drops, in comes the Chronosphere on the Klinks, the rest of the team is there as well.
Reveal?
They have still a roar available if they really want to. The reveal is just not there though. Doesn't matter, he pops his BKB, leaves the reveal, and is fine indeed. There goes the OD put under Peter Spirit. He can't get out, that's another four dead, and it is actually happening.
What?
What a messy fight that was.
What?
And there's a gem on the floor as well that is massive. Can they ward even more if they actually find it, which is, you know, we'll see if they actually do. Ooh, that's a speedy move.
When your Nyx gets...
And Roshan is up!
And Roshan's alive, yep. When your Nyx gets caught like that, you either go all in or you go all out.
And it was like half
and it was like half and half, like Void time walked in, then blinked, then went back and chronoed the OD who had already BKB'd. There's no Miranda, no Klinks nearby because he jumped so far ahead of the rest of his team.
I actually did not think this game could actually be turned around, but they're actually doing it. And
there's always a way, Shiva.
There's always a way. And this fight wasn't all about that Aghanim Scepter. This fight was just about positioning, decision-making, and mostly decision-making. The decision to fight or not to fight, and go in, and on who to focus, and yeah. There was panic all the time, too. Once that smoke broke.
Yeah. Like, where is he? He's here. He's somewhere. Sentries? Sentries?
Sentries? Who's in detection? Oh, you can only imagine the team chat at that point.
That's like Sing Sing just screaming at people.
Yes.
Or Cancel. Just listen. There's a Nyx.
Yeah, because his smoke was the one that broke.
Yeah.
Oi, oi, oi.
His near me buddies.
I believe, though.
Bloodlust on the OD.
He's got a Cheese as well.
Feels good.
Aegis in the hands of the Weaver so he can save even more people. Moonlight Shadow, you not... sure why. I do think the start of it gets... Wait a second. Are they going to pick up the gem?
They're
going to pick up the gem!
They have Gem Ogre.
They picked up the gem.
I thought Ogre saw them. What? Oh, the dodge! Cancel! He four-staffed out!
Detours! There you go! Chronosphere by the...
Time lapse! Got him!
Got him indeed. Oh, let's see if they can take down this Klinks. They roared him up. Bamba will die for it, but it is worth it as Council is just going absolute ham. Boogie and Sing Sing targeting the Varan. In the meantime, he's trying to do what he can. He actually is doing a lot. The time lapse is still there, though, in the BKB as well. It's 4-4-3. Gems all around. Faces Void does get out alive, but he's the only one. Look at the panic also with the Observer Wards. It's like,
yeah, oh. I know, I saw them. Like, Dire was just like.
It's both sides, too. Both teams did it.
Just throw them.
Both teams placed all the Observer Wards. Gems are flying left and right. They should be able to catch up both of them. Another fight, though, where both of the cores of Bean Boys survive. Oh, I'm going to lose my voice over this game.
I was so sure that Ogre had seen the Mirana coming in because he was holding a gem, but they must have done this, like, run around the trees where they were both in fog and not seen each other. Dire's top tower. But then they just walk up to that high ground where their shrine used to be and like, yep, Chrono has not landed. Hansel did a really nice four staff move to get outside of it.
Number one. There's a Chronosphere. Up on one only. Weaver has got the time lapse available, but cannot cast just yet. The time station is still there. There's still, yeah, he's still time lapse that in the Chronosphere. Or rather, the roar is there. Sing Sing has to be careful.
Yes,
still the Aegis though, so should be okay for the moment. Face of Void bot back instantly. Mirana has got that Moonlight Shadow. Will be visible in a second. We'll have that Starstorm. Oh, BKB turned on. He does pop the Aegis, but it might cost Nisha's life. No, he's okay. And is Weaver okay is the question. Has got that BKB and she's away. They got the melee racked, but the chase is on. The blink forward is there. Chronosphere in 20 seconds. Bambo should be okay though, especially with that boar though.
What's happening? Shiva, what's happening?
Nyx Assassin is still chasing. The dust is popped. Doesn't catch Nyx Assassin. And the appeal is there. Bambo is not going to live through this one.
Or is he?
Or
Bambo is the master. Oh, never mind.
His hawk lives on.
His hawk lives. He released his soul into the air.
Yeah. Bambo still has buyback. He should be fine.
Oh, boy.
Oh, this game.
And now a Scythe of Ice for the OD. I swear this game should have been over like 20 minutes ago.
Mm-hmm.
These Bean Boys, like you said, they had the resilience to like stay in base and they knew when they could take team fights. There have been a few little mess ups of Chronos, but this one's perfect.
Faces the Void, gets the Weaver. Where's the follow up? There's a kick. Misses. The kick was very unfortunate. In the meantime, Klinks might actually live. He has got the Urn Charge on him. He will be fine. Beastmaster is still the only one dead on the board, and that means that even the Chronosphere wasn't successful. Nyx Assassin. There's a gem available on that Rubik, I believe. Yes. He has to be very careful. Where's the other gem? Ogre has a gem as well. Teleport out in the Glimmer Cape. He's fine. Top lane is defended by Cancel. And more people coming in bot lane from alternate attacks. Talk to me, Gareth. What's happening?
Well, first of all, Bambo just tried to TP to a hawk that was dying up on top lane. He tried a sneaky little move where he could cut the wave. But
unfortunate.
I didn't see what happened to the Klinks. I just suddenly saw that he was on like 100 HP and running away with BKB on him. I think the OD had a little bit to do with that.
Yep.
A little bit of a skirmish over there. But again, Void, he knows that it's a good... Okay, like... Separating good Chronos and useful Chronos is, I feel, a very important thing to do right now. So, like, a good Chrono is, you know, catching the right target, catching multiple targets in a good place.
And sometimes catching multiple targets is not enough if none of them are good.
Yeah. But then, like, a useful Chrono is catching the right target at the right time, and your teammates are ready to jump in on that.
Yes.
But Void seems to overreach just a little bit by, like, 1,000 range or something, because he has Time Walk and Blink. Whereas Klinks only has a Blink Dagger. The Mirana, sure, has Leap, but she has no Blink. You don't want to be using these abilities to everyone all in onto a Chrono to get there, so you want your damage dealers to be near enough by that they can just walk to the Chrono and then do damage. But Void is just, I don't know, one step ahead of his team, almost.
Yeah, in about. You mean literally a step ahead?
Literally, yeah. literally one step ahead. Okay. Where's Mr. Wu? Where's Malini? He's gonna get very upset soon.
Oh,
but
I'm sure he's
item progression of the Dire has stalled pretty significantly. You know, we've seen these items on them for a long time. They're not moving forward. And it comes back to what you asked about the Mirana's item build, right?
Yeah.
And we did touch on the BKB plus Lincolns. She's gone for the double defensive itemization, but Bloodthorn will give
her...
Yep. Gets a full Bloodthorn. Completes it and sends it out to herself. So at least she fills a little gap there in their items. You know, there's no no Lincolns on Weaver, but there is a BKB on Odie and Weaver, of course, that they do have to deal with.
She went all in, though. There's no buyback available.
Yeah.
She has no Golem anyway, I guess. That is going to be Nyx Assassin dead before the fight even starts. Yep, that's the case. There is a buyback available, though. There is, in the meantime, a battle. Oh, that Chrono Spear did not hit Cancel. Doesn't matter. Cancel does die. No time lapse available for him. Nice kicks. This is our Spirit. Laying down some groundwork for the rest to finish up, but the time lapse is there for Sing Sing. Can he get some kills on board? Nyx Assassin will die for the second time if he's not careful. Mirana gets kicked away, and the hammer, that's the hammer that we all been talking about all that time. It is Cancel that gets him. Cancel. Where did Cancel go?
He's switching targets. Like, he knows that guy's dead, so he sees the Earth Spirit like 600 range southeast of him and blinks there. I didn't even, I saw him blink. I was like, where are you going? Kill the guy that's in front of you. And he's like, I've got someone else.
Buybacks.
No.
Is this game?
It's very not good.
For
alternate attacks. I mean, Weaver has a Desolate. At least tier 4s are forfeit. They've got to
live. They're not even going for the bottom lane. They're going to go for the game.
Yeah. I mean...
But he gets hexed. And he should be dying from that as well. Astral Imprisonment to save the Glinks for later. Glinks might not live through this either. Glinks head start. Turn on speak. Oh my god, this Weaver's doing so much damage. Oh, the time lapses are there to help out. That is nobody having buyback. This looks to be Bean Boy's first win here for the Kiev Major Qualifiers. And in what fashion? Alternate attacks, they also have not got a single win on board.
Yeah.
And they lost in such a devastating fashion.
I just want to go back to the moment where Void chronoed an Ogre.
Yeah, that's where it happened.
That's a not good chrono and a not useful chrono both rolled into one.
Yep. And that's also the first fight where Weaver had an Aghanim Scepter, a good Aghanim Scepter on the Beastmaster, where he actually got full life back on Bambo.
I mean, it's so difficult under pressure, you know. The Void is the one hero that can win them the game, and he has to consistently land, you know, 1, 2, 3-man chronos on the key targets being Odie, Weaver, and or Sexy Bambo's Beastmaster. And if he doesn't, the fight is going to go poorly. If not, they just get smashed completely. Having that much weight on your shoulders, you know, you know that Nisha and Exotic Deer can dish out damage. They just need that initial jump in. But if you're caught in this position where you've jumped in 2 or 3 times in a row and been a little bit too far forward, you could see him being very timid on the back end. He was kind of near that ward spot, near the spire, sort of to the east of the fight where that ramp goes down into the mid lane for the Dire. And he was just running backward and forward, waiting for the perfect moment. Because there was Cancel alone, there was Ogre alone. The spread from the Bean Boys was so wide, so wide across that area that he couldn't get a decent chrono. And in the end, he was like, well, I've got to go. I have to go now. I have to catch someone. He very nearly caught 2 on the edge of the chrono, but in the end, it wasn't enough.
In the end, it was not enough.
44 to 42.
What a game that was.
It was it wasn't like a tense, sort of on edge, even game. It was a swing
back and forth.
Like,
yeah.
All of a sudden, this team has won the game, apparently.
Yeah, that's how fast that can go in Dota 2.
Cool.
So, unfortunately, though, it still only puts one win on the board for Bean Boys, as they need a couple more if they want to make it through to the playoffs. But they have more chances tomorrow. Goes for both teams. They are done for today. They will continue tomorrow with their games. On this very stream, we'll continue with 4 Protect 5, and they will go up against Team Secret. So stay tuned for a cast of me and Odie Pixel. And yeah, that should be fun. So, Gareth, ta-ta. Do you say that in the UK?
I do not. I'm sure people still do. Tally-ho, old chaps. What? Yes, yes. It's tea and scones.
And with that...
Mute me now.